In this video, we're going to finish the Mixture Word Problems worksheet under the Infinite Algebra 2 tab on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Let's pick up where we left off with number 9. So number 9 says, to build the garden of your dreams, you need 10 feet cubed of soil containing 17% clay. You have two types of soil that you can combine to achieve this. You have soil with 35% clay and you have soil with 10% clay. And it's asking us how much of each soil should be used. So as opposed to having one variable, we're going to have two variables. We're going to have an X amount of the 35% clay, and we're going to have a Y amount of the 10% clay. So we're going to have our percentage, 35%, 0.35 times X, so 0.35X, plus 0.1, our 10%, of Y, so 0.1y, and we're going to divide that by our total amount of soil, which is 10 feet cubed. So here is our total amount of clay, and here is our total amount of soil. So that will give us the percentage of clay, which is 17%, so this equals 0.17. We also know that if we have 10 feet cubed, X plus Y will equal 10 because we're combining X amount of the 35% with Y amount of the 10% to get 10 feet cubed. So another equation we have is that X plus Y equals 10. I want only one variable in this equation. So let's solve this for one variable and plug that in so that it's in terms of the other variable. So let's solve X plus Y equal to 10 for X. Subtracting Y from both sides, I'll get that X is equal to 10 minus Y. So now I can plug 10 minus Y in for X. So let me start by multiplying both sides by 10 to simplify this. My 10s will cancel out. So I'll have 0.35 times X, which we're using X as 10 minus Y. So 0.35 times 10 minus Y plus 0.1y equals 0.17 times 10, which is 1.7. My next step is to distribute 0.35. 0.35 times 10 is going to be 3.5, and I'm subtracting 0.35 times y, so 0.35y plus 0.1y, and that is equal to 1.7. So now I'm going to combine like terms, and I'm going to move the terms without y to the right-hand side of my equation. So I'm going to subtract 3.5 from both sides, and I'm going to combine negative 0.35y with 0.1y. So this is going to be negative 0.25y is equal to 1.7 minus 3.5, which is negative 1.8. Then I'll divide both sides by negative 0.25 to figure out what y is equal to. Doing this, I get that y is equal to a positive 7.2. Now that I know what y is, I can take that value of y and plug it in for y in my equation that's equal to x. So I'll get that x is equal to 10 minus 7.2, so x is equal to 2.8. So now I have my y value and I have my x value that were both missing. However, remember, x represents the amount with 35% clay and y represents the amount with 10% clay. So x is 2.8, so we're going to have 2.8 feet cubed, since that's our label for our volume, with 35% clay. And we're going to have 7.2 feet cubed, so y, with 10% clay. And this is our solution for number 9. X is 2.8 and y is 7.2. In number 10, it says that bronze costs $9.10 per kilogram. And it's made by combining copper, which costs $8.90 per kilogram, with tin, which costs $9.50 per kilogram. We're instructed to find the number of kilograms of copper and tin required to make 15.3 kilograms of bronze. So our variables will be C for copper, and we'll do T for 10. So copper costs $8.90 per kilogram. So we're going to have 8.9C, and we're going to add that to the cost of the amount of tin, which is $9.50, so 9.5 times T. This will give us the price of the copper and tin within the bronze. So let me rewrite this over here. The cost of the copper and tin within the bronze is going to be divided by the amount or the weight of the bronze, which is 15.3 kilograms, and that is all equal to the cost of bronze, which is $9.10 per kilogram. So this is equal to $9.10, or 9.1. So this is one equation that we have. Another equation that we have is that copper and tin, both of those weights will equal the weight of bronze, which is 15.3. Let's go ahead and solve for the amount of tin. So I'm going to subtract C from both sides to get that T is equal to 15.3, which was the weight of bronze, minus C. So now I'm going to take 15.3 minus C and plug that in for T in this equation so that we only have one variable so that we can solve. So 8.9C plus 9.5 T, which we have as 15.3 minus C, that divided by 15.3 equals 9.1. Next, I'm going to multiply both sides by 15.3. So that'll remove that from the denominator. And I'm also, at the same time, I'm going to distribute 9.5. So I'll have 8.9C plus 9.5 times 15.3, which is 143.35, and minus 9.5 times C, which is 9.5C. And that is equal to 9.5 times 15.3, which is 139.23. My next step, I'm going to combine like terms on the left-hand side, and I'm going to move 143 and 35 hundredths to the right side of my equation. 8.9C minus 9.5C is going to be negative 0.6C, and that is equal to 139.23 minus 143.35, which is a negative 6.12. Next, I'll divide both sides by negative 0.6 to get that our variable C is equal to 10.2. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take that variable C, which is now 10.2, and plug it in for C in our equation where we solve for T. So I'll have T equal to 15.3 minus 10.2, since 10.2 is the value that C represents, and that's going to be T equal to 5.1. Remember, T represented the weight of tin, and C represented the weight of copper. So I'm going to have 10.2 kilograms of copper, and I'm going to have 5.1 kilograms of tin. Let's move on to number 11. In number 11, Kristen wants to make 6 gallons of a 34% alcohol solution by mixing together a 24% alcohol solution and a 64% alcohol solution. How much of each solution must she use? So she wants to make a total of 6 gallons at 34% concentration, using some amount at 24% and some amount at 64%. So let's go ahead and have X be the amount of the 24% solution and Y be the amount or the number of gallons of the 64% alcohol solution. We know that X plus Y equals the total, which is 6. We also know that 0.24, changing 24% into a decimal, times X plus 0.64, changing 64% to a decimal, will be the amount of alcohol and the mixture, and we need to divide that by the volume of the mixture, which is 6. And that is equal to the concentration of the mixture, which 34% as a decimal is 3, 4. Solving x plus y equal to 6 for x, we're going to subtract y from both sides to get that x is equal to 6 minus y. So we're going to take 6 minus y and plug that in for the value of x in our other equation so that we can simplify and solve for y since it will be the only variable within that equation. So I'll have 0.24 times 6 minus y plus 0.64 times y divided by 6 equal to 0.34. I'm going to start by multiplying both sides by the denominator, which is 6, so that my 6 will cancel out. And at the same time, I'm going to distribute 0.24. 0.24 times 6 will give me 1.44. And we're subtracting, since there's subtraction between the two terms, 0.24 times y, which is 0.24y, adding that to 0.64y, and that is going to be equal to 0.34 times 6, which is 2.04. I'm going to subtract 1.44 from both sides, and at the same time, I'm going to combine my like terms, my negative 0.24y with my 0.64y. Negative 0.24y plus 0.64y will give me a positive 0.4y. And that's going to be equal to 2.04 minus 1.44, which is 0.6. Dividing both sides by 0.4, I'll get that y is equal to 1.5. So now I can take that value of y, 1.5, and plug it in for y in my equation that's equal to x. That way I can solve for x. X equals 6 minus 1.5, so x is equal to 4.5. Now remember, y represented the amount of the 64% solution, and x represented the amount of the 24% solution. So my answer is going to be 4.5 gallons, so x, 4.5 gallons of the 24% solution. And for y, 1.5 gallons of the 64% solution. And that's my answer in number 11. Let's move on to number 12. In number 12, again, we're making bronze. Bronze in this problem costs $7.05 per kilogram and is made by combining copper, which costs $6.20 per kilogram, with tin, which costs $8.70 per kilogram. We're going to find the number of kilograms of copper and tin required to make 5 kilograms of bronze. Again, let's go ahead and represent copper with the variable C and the weight of tin with the variable T. So copper, which costs $6.20 per kilogram, we're going to multiply with C. And we're going to add that to the cost of tin, $8.70, times our weight of tin, T. And that is divided by the total weight of bronze, which is 5 kilograms, and that's equal to $7.05 per kilogram. So 7.05. We also know that the weight of copper plus the weight of tin will equal the weight of the bronze. So C plus T is equal to 5 because the weight of bronze is 5 kilograms. I'm going to solve C plus T equal to 5 for C, so I'm going to subtract T from both sides to get that C is equal to 5 minus T. And as opposed to plugging 5 minus T in for C at this point, I'm actually going to simplify this equation first and then plug it in. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 5. My 5s will cancel out, and I'll get 6.2C plus 8.7T equal to 7.05 times 5, which is 35.25. Now I'm going to plug C, which is 5 minus T, in for C in my equation. 6.2 times 5 minus T plus 8.7T equals 35.25. Next, I'm going to distribute 6.2. 6.2 times 5 is 31, and we're subtracting 6.2 times t, which is 6.2t. And that is added to 8.7t, which equals 35.25. I'm going to subtract 31 from both sides. And at the same time, I'm going to combine my like terms, my negative 6.2t with 8.7t. Negative 6.2t plus 8.7t gives me a positive 2.5t, and that is equal to 35.25 minus 31, which is 4.25. Dividing both sides by 2.5, I get that t is equal to 1.7. Now I'm going to plug that value of t, 1.7, into my equation that equals c. So c is equal to 5 minus 1.7, which is equal to 3.3. And remember, c and t represented the weight of copper and the weight of tin. So I'm going to have 3.3 kilograms of copper and 1.7 kilograms of tin. And that is my final solution on the mixture word problems worksheet. If you're confused on any of this material, please leave a comment below and I'll try to answer any of your questions. And please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel.